Hey, what up, Boomer Knights? How you doing? It's time for another Boomer Adventure. Guys, today is an old-fashioned vloggity vlog. We're here at Wormslow State Park here in Savannah, Georgia. Really cool place. I took some cool pictures. Mom's coming over here. We got Mom here. Say hi, Sage.
Hi. How you doing? I need the map.
You need the map? We have a map. Where's the map? Here's the map!
All right.
Check this guy out, guys. This is I don't know what this guy is. This is
he's a ranger,
social distance Bob. That's what his name should be. He's making sure you're social distancing, wearing your mask. 6 feet. I wanted to go Special Officer Doofy. I don't know. He just looked pretty cool.
Here comes
congratulations.
When we get the parents.
All right. Get married?
Yes, sir.
Congratulations, sir.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. There you go, guys. Marriage is happening. It's a beautiful day. It's not too hot. It's not too cold. But this place is pretty cool. This is a big state park here in Savannah.
Where do we go to the right? We have to go to the right.
We got to go to the right. Okay, guys. So let's figure out where we're going. All right. So this is the William Bartham Trail.
Bartram.
My mom's going to correct me, guys. So thank you. On his first journey to Florida. Hey, Florida. In 1765, Bartram and his father, John, observed figs, oranges, peaches, nectarines, and very delicious
pomegranates.
It is spelled wrong. Okay, that wasn't me.
Delicious.
I think they spelled that wrong. Pomegranates at Wormslow.
All right.
Mr. and Mrs. Craig's Barrow the Third and the Wormslow Foundation. Erect it. I'm sorry. I think they spelled that wrong. What do you guys think? All right, so we're going to go down this trail here. Somebody's getting married. We just saw the groom. There's the bride. Let's just say congratulations to him. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You picked a good spot.
Yeah.
Except for the mud.
Sun's out now.
Yeah, at least the sun's out, yes. It's
kind
of cool. I have to film the bar there. There we go. She looks great. All right. We're going down this big-ass trail. Yeah, I don't think we could have drive over there. All right, guys, we're coming up on some ruins over here. This is what makes this park famous. Imagine the guy named Wormslow, who did the family Wormslow. They owned all of this park. They donated it, obviously, to the state, or the state took over, I guess. It's usually one of those things.
Okay, here, preserve the past.
Hold on. Mom's going to read because she does better than me.
What does it matter?
Just go ahead.
Preserve the past. Completed in the 1740s and occupied until the 1820s, these tabby ruins, the tabby is the kind of, you know what they are, right? The kind of clay they put shells in.
The shells in, like the church that we saw.
Are a living reminder of 2 centuries of Georgia history. Help our history live. Please do not go inside the fence.
Dang it.
And here's the floor plan. You want to film that?
Yes, I do.
Dating to the late 1730s, Noble Jones, 5-room, 1.5-story tabby and wood house was surrounded on 3 sides by courtyard protected by 8-foot-high tabby walls. Tabby is a local mixture consisting of sand, oyster shells, lime, and fresh water. There we go.
There you go.
Mixed in equal parts. Plus, we have some strange bug crawling across. You see it?
Oh, yeah. What is that, guys?
I don't know. That's a strange-looking bug.
Anyway,
the walls were covered with a smooth layer of quicklime plaster. Where was I? Each corner of the structure had fortified bastions with loopholes that provided lines of sight down each wall. The walls provided adequate protection against muskets and other small arms.
So I guess the wood part, what happened to it? Is it over time? Did it burn down?
Or? Yeah.
I guess over time.
Could have burned down. It could have been anything.
Down, yeah. Doesn't look like, well, I don't know. I'm not an expert. But guys, if you remember, we went to Charleston.
Let's walk around the other side.
Yeah, we will.
Over there.
Okay, hold on.
Oh, we can walk this way.
I'm just saying, if you guys remember Charleston, that church that we went to, that abandoned church that burnt down,
no, that was
had the same wall. It was in South Carolina, but we were on the way home from Charleston. Yes.
Oh, okay.
Sorry. Thank you. Okay, so Mom's going to read some more for you while we look at this wall.
Hear ye, know ye that by the wishes of His Majesty, yonder enclosed ruins are property in common of the citizens of the colony of Georgia. That her history be perpetuated for, I can't say it, generations that will be yet to be. He that doth trespass within the king's fence shall eat his supper in ye public goal in Savannah.
Goal?
Yep. That's
says,
where you put your...
That says Gaol.
Gaol?
G-A-O-L. Gaol.
I thought it was Gaol.
Mom, I think I'm reading better than you lately.
It's one of those hand things that you put your hands in.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Like the stocks?
You ever go to the fair and you could stick your head through it and look like you're in prison? That's what she's talking about. I'll put one up on... If I remember, I'll put a picture up. Well, yeah, that probably grew over time. That's crazy. This is awesome.
Palm tree.
I want to. Yeah, palm trees. Well, that just probably grew. Again, this is stuff that grew over time. Not that new.
I don't know what that tree that was in the middle of the house, unless it grew under there.
Maybe.
That's weird.
It looks pretty old, though, so maybe they did something with it. Maybe it was a table. Who knows? They did things back in the day. They were pretty cool. All right, so this is what... This is why I wish I owned a property like this. I'm going to show you guys in a second. So imagine yourself, you know, you come outside because back in the day they were outside. You take your morning, you know, you go to the bathroom. I'm not going to be discussing about it. You take your morning bathroom break and you come outside. It's a nice day because it is the South. It doesn't get that cold. It gets cold here in Georgia, probably more than Florida. But you come out and you see something beautiful like this. Imagine seeing this view every morning, guys.
What is this, Jonathan?
I don't know. I'll have to come over there and look at it in a minute. Mom's playing with something.
Oh, it's supposed to tell you things.
The original gravesite of Noble Jones
is just
beyond. Okay, I'm going to have to come. Imagine that. Let's go see what Mom's playing with, but I just wanted to show you this view. I see this view a lot because when I cross over to the bridge where I live, I see a view like this, and I love it. It's a marsh, but it's still beautiful. All right, let's go see what Mom's playing with. Are we good?
Yeah.
So this is something. I think you gotta spin it.
No, press the button now.
And now you press the button. There's a light that comes up.
You have to keep on spinning it to tell the story.
Really?
And now press the button. You can't stop spinning.
The Tabby ruins behind you were constructed in 1745. It is the oldest standing structure in the Savannah area.
Oh, wow.
Looking at it, you might think these tabby ruins just decayed with age, but they didn't. With building supplies expensive and hard to come by out in the middle of nowhere, families often reused nails and even walls when they built new homes. This original home...
Oh. Damn it.
Hey, it's a story. You gotta press it. Go ahead, go now.
The view is beautiful, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
The green and golden colored cordgrass, the shorebirds, the quiet. But this is not a view that Noble Jones would recognize. During the 1700s, European countries and their colonies fought for control of North
America. Okay, I'm tired.
Georgia.
I'm out of shape,
he's
guys.
He's out of shape.
I'm out of shape, guys.
I turn it off? Off?
Go ahead.
The Wormslow Historic Site was once the colonial estate of Carpenter Noble Jones, who came to Georgia with James Oglethorpe in 1733. The former plantation is the site of the oldest standing structure in Savannah. The rooms of the Jones Tabby House was built in 1745. Noble Jones took several roles in the colony and fought against the Spanish. The land stayed with Jones until he died and continued his descendants until the state acquired it in 1973.
So the state inquired it?
Acquired it.
They just inquired
probably it. Acquired it from back taxes, most probably.
Something, yeah. We'll have to read more on that history. But that's a little bit of history of where we're at.
Yeah.
But imagine waking up to this every morning, Mom. Wouldn't you like to wake up? I mean, we have this, sort of, but we can't see it. No. We live right
we
by it.
We see the woods, we but see, we don't see the...
Yeah, we see, like, woods like that. We're not living over there, but I'm just saying, like, actually...
This is the waters of the Isle of Hope.
There you go. But imagine seeing that every morning. It's
and
so
it's
beautiful.
500 acres.
500 acres, guys. That's incredible.
It was a... Yeah.
Like, what did they do with all this land? Besides build a house.
To,
did they do farming?
No, they defended against the Spanish ships.
So the Spanish ships would come through
here. Yeah, he was a carpenter, so I guess he just lived here.
Yeah, or something. I don't know. Oglethorpe, that's another name you hear around here a lot, because there's a road named after him.
Yeah, he was a general.
I didn't know he was a general. Well, there you go. That's incredible. Alright, guys, so we have somebody buried here. It's George Wimberly Jones Duren, and he has a road named after him here, too. He's buried here. Here, I'll show you the whole grave. Look at this. I'm going to come over here. We'll do a spirit box in a second, guys. I just want to wait for people to come by here. I don't want to do it. Yeah, I know. It's a weekend. Look at that grave, though. It's a cross. That's pretty interesting.
Oh, give me the map. It might say on the map.
It says his name right there. All right. We just found out that George Rene is not buried here. He's buried at Bonaventure.
Duren.
George Duren is not buried here. Let me stop that. George Duren is not buried here. But there's some people buried here, so we're going to do a spirit communication box. So let's see what happens. Is there anybody here who wants to communicate?
Go ahead. No way.
I think they said... I had to listen to that. Is there anybody here of the Duren family want to talk to us?
Or the Jones.
Or the Jones family? Getting much. How did you die? Did you die here on the land? I heard yes. Is the spirit of George Duren here? Hi. It's crazy. Alright. Well, I'll play it back, guys, and we'll see what we find. And you know, I'll always put the words in there if I can understand it, so let's go move on. So I just met a nice guy named Greg, right? Greg?
Yeah.
We actually did. And he was giving me a lot of history, and he gave me some cool places, guys. And he has my number. I got his number. He's going to help me find some places, maybe go out, hang out with me. Who knows? I like making new friends.
We'll vlog it together.
We'll do it for the views.
Now?
Go ahead.
No, go ahead.
You want me to walk ahead of you? Okay. Now we're just walking down this, what is this, Colonial Trail it's called?
I don't know. I didn't look.
It was called Colonial Trail. He said there's nothing much down here, but I love... guys, you know me. I love the woods. Let me fix that. That's better. If there's something you want to know about me... And it's funny. I've never went camping as a kid. Me and Mom weren't into camping.
You went camping at Frost Valley.
No, that doesn't count. That was in a cabin. That's glamping in a way.
Those are rustic.
Yeah, they are rustic. Somewhat rustic. There was bats. I don't know if you ever knew that. There was bats that were living in there. And one night...
bats in the belfry, huh?
There was bats inside the cabin. And like one night, I'm coming back. And the bats were coming out. And I had to wait for them to all go out. Because every time we punched the wall, they would start going, ee! Hello.
Hi.
Good. But yeah, guys. So it was actually pretty cool, but... You film me for a minute. You guys want to see me, right? Once in a while? I know I'm not that good looking, but you know, I'm playing. But yeah, this is pretty cool. I'm enjoying this. Mom's happy to be out. We're getting exercise. And
yeah,
this is how you get exercise, guys. I mean, it's good because you don't have a lot of people here. We're all separated. So if you guys have something like this, go to it. Get some exercise.
Well, they want to take a trip.
Take a trip. Here, come to Wormslow. You guys don't live... You live in Florida? It's not that far. Shoot. We're not near Atlanta. We're near Savannah. So, it's all good. There's actually no nice parts out by Atlanta, though.
Yeah, but we're off I-95.
We're off I-95, exactly. Well, so is Atlanta, but... But trust me, you don't want to go near Atlanta.
Yes, and I wore my Winchester shirt.
Oh, yeah. She wants me to show you guys. She's a... She's... I
a
got
ghost
her
in, hunter.
She, And this is the person... When I told her, you should watch Supernatural. I don't know if I'm going to like that. Now she's addicted to the show. And, of course, it just ended. So, carry on, my wayward son.
Yeah. White-tailed deer, coastal raccoons, and red
some
fox.
Of the animals that are here.
Ooh, look. 9-banded armadillo.
Oh, I've seen armadillos all the time.
I've never seen it like that.
Oh, yeah. Hey, I just got a question, guys. What does the fox say? Ding, 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 ding. I don't know. What does the fox say? Does anybody ever know what the fox says? She doesn't get it because she never saw the video. Now I got to show her the video. I had to, before I go, I had to explain her. I'm like, when I say, hey, Mom, listen, I'm like, Linda, listen. I had to explain that to her. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go look up Linda, listen. It's freaking hilarious. So we're on the trail. Let's go. All right, guys, check this out. There's a little bridge over here. I don't know, a little boardwalk. But guys, look at this view. This is incredible. What is it, like 10 bucks to get in here?
Nine for me.
Oh yeah, nine for Mom. She's a, well, we'll just say, we'll just keep it at that.
Old person.
You said that.
I said it.
That's incredible though. This is all marsh. This is not, well, I guess it does go out into the ocean eventually.
Yeah.
But this is all Florida, Florida, sorry, the, Georgia marsh.
You can see the water right there.
I got it in the shot.
Okay. Can I have my water talking to waters? Can you back up a little? I need the other side. That's your side.
All right, guys, check this all out. Look at these trees here. It's pretty cool. All dead trees, but still pretty cool looking. Let me straighten you guys out here. There we go. That part out and look at that.
Oh, Doctor, this trail is 3 miles.
Awesome. You want to walk back?
Which way is the easiest way back?
I have no idea. We have to walk. We have to go back to where we came from. Okay.
Hold on.
We go back and we go down that one trail. It goes back.
Battery trail.
We'll figure it out, guys. Out, guys. All right, Boomer Nights, thank you so much for watching this video. This is Wormslow State Park, guys. It's pretty freaking cool here. It's only like 10 bucks to get in. So, guys, check this road out. This is supposedly, they didn't film it here, but it looks like where they filmed Forrest Gump. Isn't that cool or what? But, yeah, guys, make sure you check out my links down below. You guys want to become a member, you can hit the link down below or hit the little join button that's up there, you know. Become a Boomer member. Become a member of the Life of Jonathan channel. It's all good. It's only $2 a month. And if you can't, thank you so much for subscribing, sharing the videos, everything. Checking out my social medias. That's all I ask for. So thank you very much. I appreciate it very much. And Boomer Nights out!